Welcome back to Press Party. I'm Katie Eastman. The coverage on JFK's death started early this year as everyone prepared for their 50th anniversary special. Press Party's Erica Mora shows us the Kennedy coverage of 2013.
President Kennedy and Governor John Connally have been cut down by assassins' bullets in downtown Dallas.
It's video clips we've all seen before. The assassination, a tragic fate, of President John F. Kennedy happened 50 years ago, a fact that's been pushed by the media days before the actual anniversary. Shows on the conspiracy theories surrounding the assassination, to shows on the Cuban Missile Crisis, to documentaries, all scheduled for the entire week leading up to and on the actual anniversary. Plus stories upon stories. But is the coverage, particularly this year, just a little too much?
The way the baby boom uses the JFK experience, both the assassination as well as those shimmering years of Camelot, to kind of constantly try and stay front and center in American life, I find appalling.
Are baby boomers and a nation glamorizing a man?
During the 60s itself, JFK was not a hero necessarily.
Or is the media simply honoring a president, his family, and a tragic event in the history of America? For Press Party, I'm Erica Mora.
So I want to read a quote from Nick Gillespie. It's very harsh. He says, "If there's one November tradition less digestible and more shart-inducing than Thanksgiving dinner, it's the seasonal and ritualized fixation over the assassination and broad legacy of John F. Kennedy." That's harsh.
Yeah, well, and Gillespie's somewhat naive. He was born at the end of the baby boom in 64, which means he has no concept in terms of really what the boom was or what Kennedy was about. What Gillespie, the reason why that Kennedy is still very highly esteemed by people of our generation is he inspired the generation to go on and do great things. We had presidents inspired by him. We certainly had people with the Peace Corps like your sister, etc. Even more so, he was a rock star within the culture. It's like, you know how we celebrate remember the anniversary of John Lennon's death, etc., or Elvis Presley's death. Kennedy was more than a president. He was a cultural icon.
And Marjorie, you wrote a column for the Boston Herald kind of in response
but
to this.
Is the great headline of the piece, JFK still dead, baby boomers still self-absorbed.
Yeah, I love that.
And, you know, but there is something to that, too, because I think we were all so young. I mean, I remember my parents when they were young. I remember that whole period of being young. I remember my sister with her room covered with RFK posters and Jackie posters and reading every book. So it's a lot of nostalgia for your youth, too. But you know, 50 years from 9/11, there's going to be a massive remembrance of 9/11. Mm-hmm. Pearl Harbor, these cultural moments everybody shares, 9/11 will probably be yours, unless there's something else, as it is my children's. This was mine, my parents' was Pearl Harbor. So I think those are big deal moments, and yeah, also the baby boomers are in charge of the media now.
So, are you self-absorbed? Do you agree?
Baby boomers are self-absorbed. No one had a baby until the baby boomers gave birth. Yeah. To the baby boomer. You know, we are.
You're so right about that. I love that call. Yeah.
What do you think about that?
Well, I mean, I think it changed the country in very dramatic ways, as I said earlier. I just think that.
So the coverage is warranted?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it was a terrible thing that happened in the history of our country. By the way, Franklin Roosevelt's death was terrible, too. And my mother kept that newspaper, you know, her entire life.
But you don't see as much coverage now of that as we do. I mean,
it was a violent death. And as somebody said earlier, he was so young.
And so good-looking. You know, Let's not forget that.
Yeah.
That matters a lot, too.
Really,
I mean, Jacqueline Kennedy is one of the most beautiful women I've ever seen.
Yeah, she was.
I would guess that if they were not quite as gorgeous, there might not be quite as much attention.
Oh, of course not.
But it's that idea of the violent death. I mean, we still commemorate Abraham Lincoln's death also. And plus, remember, 5 years after Kennedy, we had Martin Luther King Jr. and Bobby Kennedy also assassinated. And those three assassinations, I believe, and I think a lot of us believe, changed the country for the worse, that we became a lesser nation and we would have been much better had those three individuals lived.
And we see every year, too, new books are coming out. There's new conspiracy theories. Do you think sometimes when, I mean, CNN, I think, said new conspiracy theory, but it wasn't actually new. They had just, we were just talking to someone else. They're kind of beating it to the ground.
Well, yeah. I was never interested in any of them because I don't think any of them are... I think it's pretty clear that Oswald did it alone, and there isn't any evidence to the contrary, but nothing is going to bring him back, and so nothing's going to change the fact that he's gone. And so to me, as somebody who cared about what Kennedy stood for, the conspiracy theories were just sort of irrelevant and foolish to a large extent.
Thanks so much for watching. Make sure to click on our next segment, The Fall of Camelot.